G'day folks. Right, this is a bit of a quick description on base cabs and how they're made, what they do and what types of base cabs. Of course, a lot of people think that a base cab is just a speaker in a box, but there's lots of different types. I'll show you three different types. This one here is called a long throw speaker, okay? Now this is a cross section, in other words we've cut straight through it, and this here is the speaker. So when you look at it, you would just see the speaker like that. The reason it's a long throw is that when the speaker moves out, push, you get movement here and you get sound travelling this way. But also when the speaker goes back in, you almost have sound travelling backwards then. Now what happens, that backward motion goes around here, and as it's travelling around the speaker, it gets amplified, goes out faster and pushes out this way. Now this is a long throw speaker. In other words, what happens with this is that the sound will travel a greater distance than a smaller bass cab, or even a cab the same size but not with the design like this inside. This is the basis, or the basic design, of a long throw speaker. So in other words, all this here would be wood, and the sound would go along here, around, hit baffle boards inside, and then around. You may have heard of a scoop bass bin or a W bass bin. They are basically called long throw. These guys here are very good, like I said very, very quickly, for throwing bass a long distance. But from an efficiency point of view, if you do push them too hard, you can blow the speakers, alright? And also they're very heavy, very cumbersome, and very difficult to carry around. This one here is just a basic forward-facing speaker. You have the two speakers here, and you have a little porthole in the centre, and the sound will travel all the way around here and come out the front. That's how they look at from, well, that's what they look like from the front. And you've got the speakers there, and those are the centre of the speakers, and the two small holes are your ports. These sorts of speakers are ideal for club installation and band installation, or when I say band installation, for bands and moderately big size venues. Now the other one, which is what I class as the best type of speaker, are what's known as band pass. Now that looks a bit bizarre, but it's very simple design. What you have here is an enclosed box. There's the speaker. Now when the speaker moves out, okay, because you have got an enclosed box, it's the speaker, as it moves out, this part here is almost causing a vacuum in here, so it has to be pulled back really quickly. Here you have another chamber, and then that's the port. Now what happens, this is a tuned chamber to the speaker. Here we're going to go into very intricate details, but there's no point going to that at this particular point. If you look at that from a front view, the dotted line is the speaker behind a big baffle board, which is this bit here, and then those dots there, the big black dots, are the ports, and that's where the sound comes from. Now ideally these speakers, they can be made relatively small. You can have 15-inch, 12-inch, 10-inch. You may find you'll have a lot of what's known as bandpass speakers in car hi-fis, etc. You'll have a little box. And they're normally called bandpass because you do get very good sub bass. And I would recommend any mobile DJ or anything like that, forget your scoop bins, forget your W bins. If you get yourself a couple of bandpass bass cabs, they do kick ass. Alright, so where are these items used? Alright, let's say your long throw. What you're looking at there is big music halls, outside events, anything like that, where they've got to throw the sound a great distance. Then you're looking at these guys here, which are basically your run-of-the-mill. They can be very expensive, but they're ideal for sort of small mobile discos or in nightclubs where the sound doesn't have to travel so far. Band pass, again, small nightclubs where the sound doesn't have to travel as far. But then again, these guys here do kick ass, and they can go down to very, very low frequencies, and they do sound awesome. So there you go, a small insight into bass cabs, and believe me, they do look a lot better than my pictures. Practice and enjoy. Bye bye.